Hello, today's our topic is if conditions in Python language. This is a very important topic for O and A level students, and for those students who want to learn Python language. So this is basically a kind of starting of the programming language. Let's talk about the special introduction about the if condition. Why we use if conditions in Python, especially if I talk about Python language. So Python basically it's a kind of selection structure, and if statement is used for that purpose. So Python supports some logical conditions from the mathematics, like if we want to check either two variables A and B, and we want to check either A is exactly equal to B, then we'll use A double equal B. Or for not sign, we have this expression available, A not equal to B, so this will be used for that purpose. And if we want to see if A is less than B, so we'll use this sign or this expression. And for less than or equal to, we'll use this one. And next one, we have a greater than sign, A greater than B and greater than or equal to B. So these are commonly used conditions for the if statement in Python language. Let's talk about the basic structure of Python language. Basic structure of the flowcharts. By using a flowchart, we should know about how to use the if statement. So let's suppose we have a test expression or the condition here, and it can be either true or false. So if I'm talking about true, this body of the code will be expressed or executed, and then we'll move on somewhere. And if it is false, then we'll not use this code. It means we'll use some other code as well. So it is just for your understanding I have expressed in the form of flowchart. Now we'll see how this condition is used. Now how to write a simple if condition or statement in Python language. So if is a keyword. What is keyword? Basically keyword are the reserved words which have some special meanings in that particular language. So we cannot use keywords as a variable name or the constants. So here we have if is a reserved word for that purpose. See this example. Here we have A is equal to B. I have assigned A equal B. So A is equal to 33. So 33 is a value and B is 2200. So I have assigned 33 value to A and I have assigned 200 to B. And now this expression is important for understanding a simple if condition. If condition is B greater than A, then we'll use colon sign with it and then we'll write the print statement. So you can see if within if there are some gap with it. So this is called indentation. It is Python is auto indented language. It automatically indent the code as per the requirement. So we can say that this is very easy to use and very user friendly as well. Now if I talk about the same question, we'll get the output. So this is what I have explained you for this purpose. In this example, we can use two variables, A and B are the variables, and which can be used as part of the if statement to test whether B is greater than A. As A is 33 and B is 2200, we know that the 200 is greater than 33. So we'll print the screen B is greater than A. So this expression will be executed. So if what will happen if B is not greater than A, then definitely nothing will be printed because this condition is not true. Fine. Now let's see another one. As I have already told you that it is properly indented language. Indented means it arranges the code accordingly, automatically. So Python relies on indentation, white spaces at the beginning of the line to define the scope in the code. Other programming languages use curly braces for this purpose. So if statement without the indentation will raise an error, because why this code will not run, because if is not properly indented. If you are saying, you can see the previous example, print was with some gap. So because after the colon sign, it will prompt you to write something with some particular gap. So that is the proper position of the print statement. If you think that you want to write print on this side, so it will not execute or it will give you an error. So this code will give you an error. I'm sure it is clear. Now let's talk about another example. Here we have LF. LF basically a keyword as well. So keyword LF is a keyword. So all the keywords must be written in the small case because it's a case sensitive language. So keywords in the Python language, if the previous condition was not true, then try this condition. It means if B is greater than B is not greater than A, then it will check either A is equal to B. So for equal B, we'll use double equal sign. So if both the values are equal, here you can see A is equal, A is 33 and B is 33 as well. So this will print this block of code, A and B are equal. I'm sure this is clear. And now we'll move on the next slide. See this one. It's further explanation of the else as well. Now after the else is the word, else clause is the clause which will be the last clause in every if condition. If you are using more than one elif, you can try elif as many as you like, but at the last you will use else. Else means if no block of code is not running, like either A is not greater than B or A is not equal to B, or then what will happen? Then else code will be executed. So it is used for catching the conditions, or sometimes for the we can say that for debugging the code. So this is very helpful and useful for the if condition. So else is the false part. So if condition is not met, false part will be executed. So print A is not greater than, A is greater than B. In this condition, A is 200 and B is 33. So we can say that A is not greater than B. So this condition will not be true. Then we'll see either A is equal to B. No, A is not equal to B. Then else part will be executed. A is greater than B. So this else part will be executed in this code. So I'm sure this is clear. Now let's talk about another one, the short way of writing the if condition. If you have a very smaller condition and you have only a shorter part, you can write in one statement as well. So if you have only one statement to execute, you can put it in the same line for the in the Python language. So one line of statement, if A is greater than B colon sign, then one condition is written, A is greater than B, so this will be executed. So the whole condition can be, it's only a true part you have executed here. So this can be easily written as well. So shorthand if condition is else part can also be written like this. So if A is greater than B, else print B. So this is what we can have. So if you have only one statement to be executed, one for if and if one else is available, so we can put the same in the one line as well. Now, so this technique is known as ternary operator. This technique is known as ternary operator or the conditional expression as well. Or test for A is greater than B, or if statement is greater than C. Now we have three variables A, B and C, and we want to see either A is greater than B or B, A is greater than C. Then we'd have to see a logical operator OR for this purpose. And here we are checking two conditions in one if one if statement. So we can say that A is greater than B or A is greater than C. Either this condition, the first condition, or the second condition is met or the true, the whole code will be executed like this. At least at this condition it is true. At least one condition must be true for it. So you can see this one, test condition, if it is true, this body of code will be executed. Else if this condition is expressed, then it is true, then this body of the code will be executed. It is elif part. And if the whole if it is not true as well, then else part will be executed. This is else part. So it means it is telling you that else is the last part of the if condition. If you are using elif, even then you will use else as the last part. Now, nested if. Nested if basically, nest means, you can see that nesting means you are using multiple if with an if. So for that purpose we can use it. We have one if condition here and then we are checking another one if condition here as well. So in the nesting we can have, we can say that x is equal to 41 if a x is greater than 10, then above 10. So in this condition, if this condition is true, we are going to check again that if a is greater than 20, then print this block of code, else print this one. So for this if, it is the last part, so it is true. So I'm sure this is called nesting. We are using if with an if. This one is nested if. Now see a pass statement. Pass statement is very simple and this is commonly used as well sometimes. So if statement cannot be an empty, but if you use if you want to use it for some particular reason, having the statement that there is no comment with it, so you can use the pass statement to avoid any getting errors. So a is equal to 3, b is equal to 200. So we can say a is greater than b, this condition is true, then pass. Pass means you will execute, there'll not be any error in that particular code. So but pass will let the operator to execute properly without having any error. So let's start making any program and we'll see the source of code as well. I'm going to open the Python IDLE and I'm going to save any program and then we'll start understanding how to write a simple code of in Python language. File, save as. I'm going to save the file on the desktop, that is if condition, if statement.py. Now I have saved the file on the desktop and I'm going to open it again. Right click, open with IDLE. See this one, the whole code is available for you. Here I'm going to write some comments with it. Practice of if statement. So let's not talk about a is equal to 33 and b is equal to 200, same one, and I want to see if a is greater than b colon c. It is indenting, it is telling you that the code should be written from this point. If I place from here, it will not be executed. I'll show you the error as well right now. So I can say print a is greater than b and I just save the program and run. See, nothing is printed because this condition is not true. So if I write this one, that is 200 and this is 33, it should be available. So a is greater than b is printed. Now I can see that if suppose I am using any other source of code, like if I want to use elif, elif a is equals a equals b, then print a and b are equal. See, in this case I have to change the values, that is 200. So it should check elif now and it should be a and b should be equal. So see, elif part is running at the moment. If I have suppose both are the conditions not true, then I'll use the else condition, and for the else we'll not write any condition with it. It will execute invalid values. So in this case I can say that C201 run and see it is invalid values because a is not greater than b and a is not equal to b as well. Right now b is greater than a, that's why this code is executed. So I'm sure you have learned simple if conditions and so many things. So thank you very much. We'll discuss the next topic, that will be loops, and that is called iteration as well. Thank you.